Hey guys, I'm Beth. This is Read Remark, and today we're going to talk about Growing Things by Paul Tremblay. So much for joining today, guys. I'm Beth, this is Read Remark, and spooky season is right around the corner. It is October, Halloween is coming up, so what better time than now to read a collection of spooky short stories. Yay! So I'm excited to talk about Growing Things, a collection of short stories by Paul Tremblay. This is the same author who wrote the very confounding book, The Cabin at the End of the World, a book in which we don't quite know if the world was actually ending or not, but a family was taken hostage by people who thought that it was, very reminiscent of the movie Funny Games. So when I first started with Growing Things, I kind of thought that maybe it would be the same concept. It would be a group of stories that could go one way or the other, because there was one in particular, the first couple, it's like the narrator would be talking about something and you would think that things are one way, and then you would find out enough things about the person to see how deeply unreliable they are and how they're probably the ones creating all the drama in the first place. So I kind of thought the stories were going that way, but I think not now that I have finished it. I think actually it's more reminiscent of another group of short stories that I really loved called North American Lake Monsters by Nathan Ballingrud. This was a book of short stories that I read around last Halloween that had all sorts of fantastical, monstrous, horrible, supernatural things going on in it, but the real action, the real meat of the story was happening with the people themselves. That was where the real horror was. That was where the real story was. For example, there's a couple who finds a fallen angel and then eats it. But really, the crux of the story was how they were this grieving couple who had lost their daughter and were trying to find a way back to one another. So that's a total aside that I've taken you on. Let's get right back to Growing Things, because same kind of concept. There are all sorts of mythical, horrific things going on, but really, when you think about it, a lot of the drama, a lot of the action is happening with the people themselves. They're creating their own horror. One story that I really liked in particular was about dog walkers who they would leave notes, very meta, leave notes for the author throughout the story about their experience walking the dog, and the notes just got weirder and weirder to the point that it made me afraid to ever let a dog walker into my home. My very favorite story of the lot is called Our Town's Monster. It's about this town that lives in, well, the shadow of a monster who comes and historically has eaten large parts of the population. So in the town, they build all sorts of things around living in the shadow of this monster. So there are all sorts of rules, customs, traditions, different stories, mythologies, different sort of morals and mores that they try to assign to it. There's the condescension of the people who haven't been eaten against those who have, that somehow they had the upper hand. It's all sorts of different things that humans prescribe and ascribe to it, and then all of a sudden the monster comes out and eats everyone. The thing that got me is that no matter what sort of reasoning you try to attach to these monsters, sometimes biology just wins out. Monster is hungry, people are food, monster eats. All of the traditions, all of the sacrifices, the rituals, all of those things meant nothing. It meant nothing to the monster. It was all a human construct. What really mattered was monster hungry, people food, yum, 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 yum. It's just so good. So, Growing Things by Paul Tremblay. If you come to this expecting a retread of The Cabin at the End of the World, you're not going to get it. This is going to be a little bit different. Even the writing style is different. The characterization is different. But I enjoyed it quite a bit. So, really good option if you are looking for your Halloween fix of chills and thrills. Growing Things by Paul Tremblay. Check it out and let me know what you think. Thanks so much for watching. And let me know if you have any other good spooky books you can recommend. I'll catch you next time. Bye.